Hi there, my name is Paul and I work at TimeSeries. Today I'm going to show you how to use a native REST consume with Mendix. Maybe your next project needs to consume an API, or you just want to have fun and connect to one of the thousands of APIs available nowadays. Whichever the case, I'm here to show you how. For this tutorial, I have chosen to implement a Ron Swanson Quote API because Ron Swanson is a boss. Here we have the endpoint we are going to consume. If you don't have any documentation on what the response is going to be, I suggest you use something like Advanced REST Client. We use the Advanced REST Client to mock a request. There are many similar applications and you can use whichever one you like. We are going to paste our endpoint in the request URL field and press Enter to send a GET request. We are going to copy this response and use it to create a JSON structure. To create a JSON structure, we select Add, Consumed Resources, and JSON Structure. Paste the response from the mock request in the structure. Make adjustments where necessary and click Refresh to update the structure. Here we can see which attributes are available. As you can see, the quote will be in the value attribute of the wrapper object. The data then needs to be mapped to Mendix objects. To do this, we are going to create an import mapping and select the JSON structure we just created as a schema source. Select the object and attribute you need. In our case, we'll press check all and press OK. We can easily use the map automatically functionality to create a corresponding domain model. This will create non-persistent entities for our selected data. Now we're all set to use this import mapping in our microflows. In our case, we want to click a button to call the REST service and display a pop-up with a cool new quote. In our microflow, we'll use the call REST action activity. On the general tab, we want to edit the location and fill it with the endpoint. It is possible to build this endpoint dynamically using parameters, but we're going to skip that for this tutorial. Since this is a GET request, we only have to select a response handling. Here, we select use import mapping and save the top element in a variable. If you recall our mapping, the actual quote is one level deeper than the variable we currently have access to. So, we're going to retrieve the wrapper object by association. The JSON structure tells us that, theoretically, we can expect a list of wrapper objects. Since we only want one quote, we'll use the head list operation to get the first object from the list. The quote is stored in the value attribute, which we'll use in a showMessage action activity. And that's all there is to it. Now let's go reap our rewards. Run the app and click the button to get your Ron Swanson quote. For more information about REST, check out the Mendix Expert webinar by Clyde Waal or the Mendix documentation. Links to this information can be found in the description box of this video. Hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any further questions or tutorial requests, feel free to leave a comment. Thanks for watching and see you next time.